be glad to be in God's house tonight.
Amen.
Yeah. You're a lot more help than you are.
I just thank God for the opportunity to get to minister His word once again. But I think it was probably about 3 weeks ago here in Bible study. Dad's been teaching on Daniel, and man, he read this verse and it hit me like a ton of bricks. And when he read that verse, just instant, the light switch came on. And then when the light switch came on, I just started thinking about it. And I couldn't get that off my mind. And I was sitting there back in the back pew that night when he started reading that scripture. I said, boy, I hope Jimmy or Teresa didn't catch that. Because I know sometimes when you read something, they're quick to catch it. And I thought, boy, I hope they didn't catch that. Because their last Sunday, Jimmy was preaching on the promises of God. Well, it wasn't probably a month ago, God was dealing with me about that. He was dealing with me about Noah and a rainbow, and I started thinking about the promises. Well, we'll throw that one aside for a while. But when I was listening to Dad teach, I don't know the exact number of the verse, but I do know the chapter. I believe it was Daniel chapter 2. And it talks about something about Nebuchadnezzar promoting Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. Yeah. And boy, when I seen that word promoted, man, that just stuck with me. And I just thought about that word, you know, just dwelling on it. You know, I'm going to say 24 years ago, soon to be, I graduated from high school. And I believe that was the last time I was promoted. I don't think I've been promoted since. You know, my daughter, she brought a report card home the other day, and she makes the honor roll.
Amen.
But I don't think I've ever made the honor roll my entire life. I think I remember making a principal's list, but it wasn't the good one. And I still remember my old principal, Mr. Fetty. And every time I see him or he sees my mom, he says, man, that Mark, he used to be a bad character. He used to be in my office all the time, and that's a fact. I was ornery. But you know, I was thinking about the word promoted, promotion, however you want to say it. You know, we promote a lot of stuff in the world. But there's one thing that we don't promote enough of, and that's Jesus.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
We need to start promoting Jesus more. You know, you take these credit cards, Discover, Visa, and they send you a letter in the mail saying, well, if you use this card such amount of time, there's a promotion period for 18 months if you pay it off. If you can pay it off. There's a promotion period. But you know, Jesus don't have no promotion period. He paid it all. He paid it all in full. But you know, we look on TV, promoting alcohol, promoting stuff, radio, promoting everything but Jesus.
Amen.
That's all we're promoting. That's the world. You know, on air and try to sell cars, promotion here, promotion there. Don't hear nothing about Jesus. But then I started thinking, Lord, You gotta help me with this because I don't know where to take it at. So he took me to Mark chapter 10. Starting out with verse 35. And it starts out, and James and John, the sons of Zebedee, come to him saying, Master, we would that you should do for us whatsoever we shall desire. See, in this first verse, James and John, they have a request. And I thought, how many times in our lives do we have, do we make requests to God?
Amen.
And you know, lots of times, to me, they're just foolish requests. And verse 36 says, and he said to them, what would you that I should do for you? They said to him, grant to us that we may sit one on your right hand and the other on your left hand in your glory. But Jesus said to them, you know not what you ask. Can you drink of the cup that I drink of? See, he's asking them a question.
Yes. Amen.
And be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. And they said to him, we can. See, they
no idea.
And Jesus said to them, you shall indeed. See, he didn't ask them. He said, you shall indeed.
Amen.
Drink of the cup that I drink of, and with the baptism that I am baptized with, shall you be baptized. But to sit on the right hand and on my left hand is not mine to give. But it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. And when the ten heard, about it, well, they got mad. And they began to be much displeased with James and John. Dad, can you read over the word?
Father, we just praise you and we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, O God, to come before you once again. Father, we just thank you and we praise you, Lord, for your word. Father, we come before thee, O God, and we ask the loving Lord to anoint our brother tonight in the mighty, beloved Lamb of God. Lord, just speak, loving Lamb of God, your precious word. And Lord, we'll apply it to our hearts that, Lord, will not only be yours, but, Lord, will be yours. And, Father, we pray and we ask, Lord, for the anointing, Lord, throughout this service. For we ask in Jesus' name, amen.
Now, I'm just going to go through and kind of paraphrase on this. But when I read scriptures, I kind of like to try to get a kind of a vision of what's going on here. But you know, in this verse, they're asking a question. Can we sit on your right hand and your left hand? But see, in verse 10, he hasn't even been crucified yet. Because he's not crucified until, I think, 15th chapter. But I believe when they was walking to Jerusalem with the 12 disciples with him, you know, I believe probably James and John, they was probably in the back of the line and they got this brainy idea. And I believe it goes on before this that I believe their mother was Salome. I don't know how you pronounce it.
Salome.
But I think she had gave them this idea. And you know, I was thinking about this, you know, that maybe their mother she had put them up to asking Jesus this question. But you know, I was thinking about myself. You know, me being behind this pulpit, my mom didn't ask me to do it. You know, I was led by God to preach the word. You know, and I was thinking that sometimes in our lives that, you know, mommies, they like to get involved in things. And you know, thank God my mom was never that way. But you know, here she is. I believe she had put James and John up for this. So they went to ask Jesus this question. They had a request. But it says right here in verse 37, they said to him, "Grant us that we may sit." You know, and he said, "Jesus, why don't you give me this right to sit beside you?" And I wonder what Jesus thought about this thing. Because, you know, I'm thinking that James and John, they wasn't even looking at the spiritual aspect of this. They was looking at the earthly aspect of this. See, when Jesus builds his kingdom, he's not going to build it on this earth.
That's right. That's right.
He's going to build it in heaven. And, you know, to think about this in our life, if we don't do what we're supposed to do and what God tells us to do, we're not going to get promoted.
Right.
We're not going to get promoted in anything that we do in our lives. And you know, the good thing about it is, when you think about it, there ain't anybody in this church can promote me. And there ain't anybody in this church can promote you.
That's right.
That's all up to you. And you know, with promotion comes a greater job. You know, I got guys that I work with at the factory. And some of them say, "Well, I need a raise. I need a promotion." And you know, there's a couple of them ain't worth a nickel. No, I'm serious. I mean, they're plain out lazy. I mean, you're lazy. You show up late for work. And you don't take any pride in your work. And you're asking for a promotion. Now, come on. Now, what kind of manager is going to give you a promotion? It ain't going to happen. And, you know, myself, I run into people that's known me for years, and they say, "Where are you working at?" "Well, I'm still at the glass factory." "Well, how long you been there?" And I tell them, "You been there that long?" "Yeah." But, you know, the thing about it is, at my job, I have no room for promotion. I'm right here. But you know, when it comes to Jesus, there's higher expectations you can go.
That's right.
But it's all up to you what you want to do. Do you want that promotion? I do. And it says, "May I sit one on the right hand and the other on your left hand in glory." But Jesus said unto them, "You know not what you ask. Can you drink of the same cup that I drink of?" And you know, I was thinking about that cup. We really have no idea you think. But we really have no idea what was in that cup
right.
that Jesus drank of.
Amen.
That's right.
You know, I believe, you may believe different, but I believe when Jesus looked in that cup, he couldn't believe what he seen in that cup. Because you know why? It says he asked God the Father 3 times, take this cup from me.
That's right.
I don't want to drink of it. I don't want no part of it. But here you got James and John saying, oh yeah, I can drink that cup. And you know, I got to thinking about something this morning. And it's kind of something when, you know, when we was growing up and, you know, I don't remember drinking it because I don't believe my mom ever gave it to me. But I hear a lot of the older folks talking about castor oil. Oh, my. Get constipated. Mom would give you the old castor oil. Boy, I'm glad my mom never gave that to me. I cannot imagine drinking that nasty stuff. But when you think about it, I believe that cup that Jesus had in his hand, it had to be more bitter and more nasty than that old castor oil.
Amen.
And you know, I got to thinking about this today. When them kids took that, and it's not nice to talk about, but think about this. When they were constipated and they drank that old nasty stuff, it wasn't too long, they got promoted. Think about it. They got promoted straight to the bathroom. No, that wasn't a very good promotion, but they got promoted. But it worked. But, you know, I believe when Jesus looked at that cup, he couldn't believe what was in it. And, you know, for him to ask the Father to take it away 3 times, it had to be bad. And it said, and be baptized with the same baptism that I am baptized with. See, in order to be promoted in this life, I don't care what's in that cup. You may not want to drink it. Sometimes you're going to have to. Sometimes you're just going to have to take it, get it done. You're going to have to do it. You know, my kids back there, sometimes they don't want to take cough medicine or something because they like Mucinex or something because they said it tastes nasty. And I tell them, I said, before you take that medicine, my grandpa taught me, I said, hold your nose. I said, you hold your nose, drink it straight down. I said, you won't taste it. But my grandfather taught me that. But verse 39 says, and they said to him, we can. Boy, they were so sure they could do it. Positive they could do it. And Jesus said to them, you shall indeed drink. I'm not going to ask you. You shall indeed do it. Drink of that cup. And with the baptism I am baptized, with you shall be baptized. And you know what? I am so glad that I am baptized with Jesus 100% baptism. You know, there are so many things going around nowadays. And you know, the verse says, people having the form of godliness and denying the power thereof.
Amen.
You know, I'm glad tonight I don't have to deny that power.
That's right. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I know what Jesus can do. And verse 40 says, but to sit on the right hand and on my left hand is not mine to give. But it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. See, Jesus can't say whether you're going to sit there or not. You have to prepare yourself for that. You know, if you don't prepare yourself for it, we're not even going to be worthy to stand beside Jesus. And, you know, I was just thinking about heaven. This is a preparation period on earth here. If we don't get prepared, there's not going to be no promotion. You know, I can think of a lot of other things in this world that I want to get promoted in, but it's not worth it. It's not worth getting promoted on earth. But I want to get promoted in Jesus.
Right. Amen.
That's what we need to do. And verse 41 says, and when the 10 heard it, they began to be much displeased with James and John. My gosh. This is just like the church nowadays. If a brother or sister wants to do something in the church, you got 10 others talking about them. So let me ask you a question. How do you know God's not dealing with them? How do you know God wants to use them in a mighty way? For His glory. To raise them up. You know, the thing of it is, if you don't want to be promoted and be used, God's going to use somebody else.
Amen.
But I just wrote a few things down here. Promote. The farther progress of support or actively encourage. Now, as people in a church, that's what we need to do. We need to encourage people. And it says to advocate, to farther advance, to assist, to aid, to help, to nurture. Now, ask yourself this question. How much do we help, assist, aid, help, nurture? See, we're lacking at the church.
That's right.
And I'm just going to read a few scriptures here. Genesis 12 and 2 says, and I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and I will make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. Too many people trying to make themselves great. Ain't going to happen. If you do, sooner or later you're going to fall. Amen. The only one can make your name great is God.
That's right.
Only one. And you know, there's so many people in the world trying to promote their self, to get the name, to get started in something. Let me tell you, brother or sister, if God wants to promote you, He's going to promote you.
That's right.
There ain't no promoting yourself.
That's
right. That's a train.
You do what God wants you to do, and God will take care of the rest.
Amen.
In Psalm 75, 6 and 7, listen to this one. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. But God, it says, God is the judge. He putteth down one and set up another.
Amen.
That's right.
See, we need to leave this up to God. See, if we go back to the first part of Scripture we started reading here, see, James and John's trying to do this on their own. You ain't going to do it on your own. In Psalm 78 and 70 says, He chose David also his servant and took him from the sheepfold. Now think about this. Here David is out in the field taking care of sheep. And God looked down and he said, this is the guy I want to promote right here.
Right.
Amen.
He took the lowest guy on a totem pole, a shepherd. And he said, I'm going to do something with him. And I wrote down here, David was a man after God's own heart.
Amen. Amen.
See, if God sees that you have a sincere heart, He's going to do something with you. In 1 Peter 5 and 6, humble yourselves therefore under the mighty hand of God, that He may exalt you in due time. Not in your time.
That's right.
God's time.
Amen.
He didn't give us a specific date. He says in due time. But another thing that I wrote down here, I'm going to ask you another question. Do you want to be promoted or do you want to be demoted?
That's right.
See, I don't never want to be demoted.
That's right.
And the meaning of demoted is to give someone a lower rank or less senior position, usually as a punishment.
That's right.
And tonight, I'm not going to preach long because I've been kind of watching the clock around here. Trying to stay on target here. But my question tonight is, you need to ask yourself, do you want to be promoted or demoted in God?
Amen.
I hope you pick promoted. Because you know, if you take the word demoted, see, promoted, you're going forward. Demoted, you're going back. And you know, we got to be very careful. There's a fine line between that. And you know, I believe that if you don't watch, you can get in that demoted stage. And you can get in that backslidden condition.
My feet and my feet.
Now come on.
That's right.
You can step back. And you know, I don't whatever say step back and say, well, I want to be where I used to be at.
No.
I don't want to say that. I want to stay where I'm at now, and I want to move forward. You know, lots of times we say, well, and I've probably said it, I want to be where God wants me to be, and I want to be where God can use me, and I want to be where I hear God's voice.
Amen.
When's the last time that you actually heard God's voice? You know, what a wonderful thing to hear God's voice. No, just to sum it up here, we was headed down to Charleston last weekend, and me and Melissa, I was telling Wally Montaigne about it. We was just conversating on our way down. And, you know, sometimes as we say as wife and husbands, we say, well, you know, our communication really stinks. And we were just laughing and joking around about it. And as she was talking, it just hit me. Ding, ding, it just hit me right there. And I said, hold on, stop. I said, I got something to say. I said, you know what just dawned on me? I said, I was just thinking about the beginning of time, Adam and Eve. I said, God gave them one commandment. I said, you can eat anything in this garden, but don't eat of that one tree right there. So Eve, she strolled on over there. I'm just going to say it was an apple. She strolled on over there and she took the apple off the tree. She said, oh, Adam, please. You got to try this. This is really good. And I believe first Adam really didn't want to eat of it.
Oh, sure.
But he did anyway.
Yeah.
He took a bite of that apple.
Twisted his finger.
And you know, when he took a bite of that apple, I believe they looked down and went, oh, look, we're naked. So what do? They take off running. They go over in the bushes and they start grabbing some fig leaves and they start covering themselves up. And I believe instantly they felt bad about what they did. Because they recognized they were naked. And I told Melissa, I said, as they were over in the bushes trying to cover themselves, I said, if man and woman wasn't arguing from the beginning of time and having a communication problem, I said, I bet you, and I almost guarantee you, that Adam and Eve was over in the bushes blaming one another. Now, tell me, from the beginning of time, that man and woman didn't get along. It never happened.
Never will.
So, to leave you with that little thought, next time you and your better half has a little spat or a little disagreement that you just don't agree on, I want you to think back to Genesis and say, honey, it's all right. Because I know Adam and Eve's bad. But tonight, as you come up to the altar, tonight I want to ask yourself tonight, do you want to be promoted or demoted? But I hope tonight that your answer is promoted. Because you know what? Anything that you do for God with a willing heart, God will help you.
Right.
But you know, we have to have that willing heart. And you know, I'm just so thankful that God changed my heart. You know, lots of times people may see things in there. But I'm going to tell you what, I'm perfect in God's eyes. Because you know, I every day I thank God for His blood. Because you know, the blood covered it all.
Amen.
So tonight, come up, pray, repeat, pew, whatever you want to do. But tonight, if you have anything, ask God. If you need a healing tonight, ask God. If you need a miracle, ask God. If you're having some kind of issue in your life, ask God.
Amen.
That's what He wants you to do. Thank you.
Amen.